This is how exercise and dieting increase your need for riboflavin. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about how exercise and dieting both increase your riboflavin requirement. When you exercise, you're burning more fat, and this is especially true if you're engaging in low to moderate exercise, what people tend to think of as endurance or cardio exercise. You also are going to burn more fat when you're dieting because you're losing fat. In order to get rid of the fat tissue that's on your body, you got to burn it somewhere. So you're burning more fat. In both those cases, your riboflavin requirement is going to go up. And what we see is that exercise regimens that are on the order of 20 to 50 minutes a day for 6 days a week that are focused on cardio exercises like bicycling or jogging are going to increase the riboflavin requirement somewhere between 40 and 60%. In fact, dieting to lose weight does the same thing. And when you combine dieting and exercise together like that, you are more than doubling the riboflavin requirement. Now, on the flip side, what we don't see is that you need more riboflavin to be to get better performance out of your exercise. What we don't see is that if you're a competitive athlete, you need to take high-dose riboflavin supplements so that by getting 10 times the requirement for riboflavin, you can burn 10 times more fat and get 10 times more performance. We don't see anything like that. What we also don't see is that when you're dieting, you need to take 10 times more riboflavin than you would otherwise need so that you can burn 10 times more fat and you can lose 10 times more weight. So what we're not seeing is that extra riboflavin improves performance at exercise or improves weight loss. What we are seeing is that when you exercise or lose weight, the increased demand to burn fat is diverting riboflavin into fat burning. So you're plenty capable of fat burning, but that diversion of riboflavin into fat burning comes at the expense of using riboflavin to support your antioxidant defense and protect your tissues from wear and tear. In other words, your body knows that right now it is immediately important to support fat burning. And that means that because protecting your tissues from long-term wear and tear is not an immediate concern, that's in the interest of your long-term health, you're taking riboflavin away from that and putting it into what is most immediately necessary. So if you are an athlete or if you're losing weight, your primary concern in your mind might be on your performance or on your weight loss. But if you're frequently engaging in dieting or exercise, you need to think about your riboflavin requirement going up because that's what's going to matter for your long-term health. In the case of dieting, it's particularly important to remember that when we're dieting, we're eating less food. That means that we have fewer opportunities to get the riboflavin that we need, and yet dieting itself increases the amount of riboflavin that we do need. In the next episode, I'm going to talk about how to meet these riboflavin requirements by eating good food. This episode is brought to you by Vitamins and Minerals 101. This is my new free 30-day course providing one lesson a day on each nutrient delivered straight to your inbox. It can go to your email or it can go to your Facebook Messenger. If you get the Messenger version, it's taught by Chris Masterbot, my baby bot. It's more interactive. There are more emojis and there are more jokes. But both email and Facebook Messenger are incredibly educational. Each lesson covers why the nutrient is important to your health, how to know if you have too little or too much or the wrong balance with other nutrients, how to get it from food, and when you should think about supplementing. It is not a technical or advanced course. It is completely minimum in its technical jargon, and it is designed for the beginner with no background in nutrition and no background beyond high school in the basic sciences. Nevertheless, many people who have backgrounds in nutrition are saying that it is an amazing refresher course full of nuggets of valuable information in each lesson. Sign up completely free by Facebook Messenger or by email at chrismasterjohnphd.com/101.
This episode is brought to you by Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. This is my recipe to empower you to banish any deficiency or nutritional imbalance from your body. I've been through the pain of my teeth falling apart, my stomach being in constant pain, and my OCD going off the rails during my stint with veganism, to the point where panic attacks were the norm and I was afraid to eat any of the food in my house. I've been through the path of healing using nutrient-dense animal foods to nourish all the systems of my body and become a new person. But I've also learned that my needs change over time. The red meat and liver that were so healing in my recovery from veganism later started sapping my energy and brain power, only to find out that I'm genetically predisposed to iron overload and need to manage it with blood donations. And I've learned from friends, colleagues, and clients that everyone is different. Your needs are not mine. Mine aren't what they were 10 years ago. Yours won't be what they are now in 10 years. That's why we need a precise recipe to know exactly what's missing, exactly what's overloaded, exactly what's imbalanced, and an action plan to fix things, and a way to measure our success. That's what I've done with Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. Get your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet and use the code LITE20, that's L-I-T-E and the number 20, LITE20 to get 20% off. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.